Was the president telling the truth about your canceling the meeting he wanted so desperately to have with you?
No, I'm still excited about meeting with the president. I think basically his staff gave him some incorrect information because they know that we have been wanting to meet with him with regard to the high prices of prescription drugs.
So if you get a call from the White House, you would go over there ASAP and have this be, I know you want to speak about drugs, you want to speak about that specific issue, but he clearly wants to have a broader conversation, not just with you, but with other members of the Congressional Black Caucus. Would you recommend to the Congressional Black Caucus that the leadership go over with you to the White House and have this kind of meeting with the president?
Yes, I would, but keep in mind, one thing he did not say is that on January the 19th, Cedric Richmond, the chairman of the Congressional Black Caucus, wrote to the president asking for a meeting, and they have gotten no response to date. And so maybe the president will give him a call tomorrow, but I'm happy to meet with the president. Keep in mind, this is my president, this is your president for the next 4 years.
Was it odd that the president asked White House correspondent April Ryan to set up a meeting between himself and the leadership of the Congressional Black Caucus?
Yeah, I thought that was a little different, but I imagine what happened is he saw an African-American woman connected with the Congressional Black Caucus and said maybe they're friends. So, that's one of the things that I wish the president would do. Every time he talks, by the way, about the inner city, he has negative things to say. Wolf, I wish he could walk into some of the areas that I live in and where people are doing extremely well, taking very good care of their families. He needs to have a bigger picture of the African-American communities and our cities. Our cities are thriving places, and it should not always be said in a negative tone. But I am glad that he recommitted himself to helping with issues like education and healthcare and things of that nature. And I would say to the president, because I'm sure he may be watching, Mr. President, it was one thing to campaign, it's now time to govern. People need you to be the president that you said you would be during your inaugural address. You said that you would make sure that the power was given back to the people. Well, there are people in my district that want you to succeed. But Mr. President, how they define success is you lifting up their lives. And by the way, make sure that you talk to your fellow Republicans in all these states and tell them to stop trying to stop African Americans, Hispanics, and others from being able to vote.